Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today I'm going to talk about the water tube boiler. This is the first part of the water tube boiler. In today I'm going to explain you why the water tube boiler came into the picture. What drives the requirement of the water tube boiler? As the water tube boiler is designed, it is thin type tube design. Why it is thin type tube design and how it is designed, I'm going to explain you, and what are the problem regarding a thin tube design, that I'm going to explain you. This is the first part of the water tube boiler, and the second part of the water tube boiler will be uploaded soon, in which I'm going to explain you the component of water tube boiler. Before beginning the video, I want to tell you that I have made the video regarding the Cochrane boiler, Scotch boiler and waste heat recovery boiler, including composite boiler and exhaust gas boiler. If you want to know about this type of boiler, you can click on the I button right now showing above, where you will go to the play section and you can watch the video. So let's begin the video of the water tube boiler. So what drives the requirement for the water tube boiler? For operating machinery at high efficiency, higher temperature, steam requirement increases, which led to the increase in boiler pressure. So what happened? As the pressure in the boiler increases, why the pressure in the boiler increases? Because of the higher temperature steam requirement, and this higher temperature steam requirement causing the increase in the boiler pressure led to the development of a design which can accommodate such increased pressure. So as the boiler pressure increases, the requirement for modification in design for having high efficiency plant led to the water tube boiler discovery. So what happened, as I told you, that boiler pressure increase causing the higher efficiency plant discovery led to the water tube boiler. Now water tube boiler basically is thin tube design. It has been found that the small tube boiler have a better heat exchange efficiency than a large diameter tube. So as you all know that the small diameter tube is having a high heat exchange efficiency compared to a large diameter tube. Why? Because the large diameter tube having good amount of thickness will take a time to exchange the heat compared to the small diameter tube. There are several reasons for that, why the thin cell is preferred. But before that, I want to talk about that as the plant efficiency need to be increased, therefore the pressure need to be increased. Why? Because at that time the development of turbo alternator and the steam driven alternator has come into the picture, and for that superheated steam requirement was increasing. For that the boiler pressure was increasing, and hence the water tube discovery came into the picture, and which has been found out that a water tube is designed such that the generating tube and the component of tubes are thin tube, so that to have good heat exchange, and hence it will lead to the larger steam generation in a small amount of time with good quality. So this led to the thin cell design. Now what is, as per thin cell formula, we know pressure into diameter by twice into thickness. Okay, so by thin cell formula, you know, pressure into diameter by twice into thickness. So as you can see, if this pressure is increasing, then we have to decrease the diameter so that to keep the thickness within the reasonable limit. If the pressure is increasing and if we increase the diameter, then in that case we have to increase the thickness also. So what will happen? Ultimately, the heat exchanging efficiency will reduce. So to accommodate, to keep the thin cell formula within limit, what we are doing, as the pressure is increasing, we are reducing the diameter so that the thickness can be kept within a reasonable limit which can be made and molded. Now heat conduction, as we know from the formula, temperature difference means, what are the temperature difference of the heat conduction means before the heat conduction start and after the heat conducted, the temperature difference into the area where the heat is conducted and into a time means the temperature required to increase the heat from suppose 50 to 90 to a certain area, and the time required for increasing temperature by thickness of the tube. So as you can see that the other factor remaining constant, such as temperature difference, area and time, decrease in the thickness if we decrease the thickness, then the heat conduction will increase. So basically what I mean to say that if the thickness of the tube is decreased, in that case the heat conduction will increase because it is inversely proportional. So if we decrease the thickness, then heat conduction will be fast and much efficient. So in thin cell, what we are doing, we are decreasing the diameter, we are reducing the thickness, so that we will get a higher pressure, better efficiency plant. Large surface area. Large surface area means large heat exchange in a short span of time. Okay, so surface area is a very important factor for a heat exchanging process. To increase the surface area, in earlier models such as in exhaust gas boiler, I have told you that we are providing mild steel fins so that we can increase the surface area, because surface area increases the time for the heat conduction and also it provides better heat efficiency. So for example, one diameter 100 mm tube and 450 mm diameter tube having approximately equal cross-sectional area. So the cross-sectional area of the 100 mm tube and the 450 mm tube will be same, but the surface area will be twice of the 50 mm tube compared to the 100 mm tube. As you can see in this diagram, suppose in the smoke tube boiler, this was the tube which was used for the steam pressure generation. But in water tube boiler, this type of thin tube is used for a water steam generation. So as you can see, if you place the four tube like this, the surface area will be twice compared to this one tube. So for that reason, the thin tube design is preferred for better heat exchanging efficiency. So basically, as you can see, the whole thing is revolving around the heat exchanging efficiency. It means the flue gas generation is same for both the smoke tube and water tube. Main thing is the heat exchanging. It means in that amount of span of time, it has been found out that if we want to increase the efficiency of plant, we have to design a plant in such a way that it can take the maximum amount of heat from that flue gas. For that, it has been found out that the thin type tube design water tube boiler is best, because it has good surface area, it has good heat conduction, it has good ease of construction. Okay, so let's see what is the ease of construction. Thin tube boiler is easier to manufacture. First thing, why easier to manufacture? Because it can be easily bent, it can be easily expanded, and it can be easily bell mounted. And above all, it is also lightweight. So these are the manufacturer benefit which are also provided by the thin tube boiler compared to the large tube. So these tubes are easy to bend, easy to expand, easy to bell mount, and overall weight compared to this tube is much less. So, and hence it is improving the efficiency of the plant. Now, where is the these pros, there is also cons. So what are the problem which led by the thin tube design? So as you know, as the tube is thin wall type, to ensure that it doesn't get overheated, we need to take care of the following. Now the problem, as you can see, this thick tube doesn't subjected to the problem of overheating, but these tubes are subjected to the problem of overheating. For that, what we are doing, let's see. Efficient water circulation need to be maintained to ensure that the natural water circulation of water is carried out on the water tube boiler. To facilitate natural circulation, the tubes are sloped at the angle of 15 degree. So the most efficient point is that the water circulation should be natural and should be always in a natural circulation mode to facilitate the natural circulation. If the water circulation is natural, in that case, good heat exchanging efficiency will be achieved. What is natural efficiency? If you want to know, I have already made a video, you can watch that and you will get the idea. Now, what is second problem is a scale formation. Scale formation inside the tube is avoided by the use of a good quality feed water, such as distillate water with a closed feed system. Very important point. Now, in smoke tube boiler, I have told you the smoke tube boiler was thick tube boiler and large in diameter. Therefore, the problem of heat exchanging efficiency was not much, even if there is a deposition of carbon particle inside the tube. But the problem with the water tube boiler is that the water tube in water tube boiler, water is passing inside the tube. And if there is a scale accumulation inside the boiler, then there will be a problem because it will lead to the overheating. And as the boiler is thin type tube design, it may get overheated and get burned, and hence water may leak. For that reason, good efficient quality of distillate fuel with distillate water is used so that it will have a minimum scale formation, and for to reduce a scale formation, chemicals are used so that to avoid that. For that reason, the boiler water should be very good and should be a closed fuel system. But in a smoke tube, the boiler was water can be used was a poor quality and it was open system. So that is the deficiency of the thin tube, that the system should be closed type and the water quality should be good type. And second is the water circulation should be very efficient. Now, as I have told you, as you can see, this is the steam drum, this is a water drum. Now, as you can see, this is a generating tube. This generating tube mainly, as you can see, how thin is the tube design. This tube design is thin in nature and it is sloped at 15 degree angle circulation so that to facilitate water circulation and water, if the water get heated, is easily get up, and if it is cool, it easily get down. So as you can see, the tube is thin, therefore it can easily be bent, easily be expanded, easily be mouthed and lighter in nature, and overall weight and overall cost of construction is less. Now one more thing you can see here, this tube is stacked in such a way and is bended in such a way because of the thin cell tube design. So I hope you have learned that why the water tube boiler came into picture, because of the high pressure requirement. The second thing, why the water tube boiler was thin tube design, because of several things. What are that? Heat conduction, surface area, ease of construction. These are the point which you can say that this, for that reason, thin tube design is preferring water tube boiler. And what are the problem, as I have told you. So I hope you like the video. Please do subscribe and share, and please share with your friend. And if you want to know about the water tube boiler and further about the boilers, you can go to the play section of this Marine Engineering Hub and you can watch that. Have a good day, friend. Goodbye.